journey of Susie King Taylor. Born a slave in Lincoln County on the Isle of Wight. The circa 1848, in terms of the dialect, is a mixture of Elizabethan English for the white community, and the enslaved have a potpourri of language and dialect that is a mixture of French and Spanish and Portuguese and West African tongue, which is detected as Gullah and Geechee. That language is still practiced today, and there are officially 4 states: North Carolina, South Carolina, Georgia, and some parts of Florida, to include Jacksonville on down to St. Augustine, Florida. The cast is so excited to be here this afternoon to perform for you. Some are professionals and others are first-time performers, to include our young people this afternoon. Again, welcome to the History Theater. We present to you Susie King Taylor. What a wonderful revolution.
In the sun to help prolong her vitality. mother. One of her daughters, named Susanna, was 100 years old when she died. She died of a stroke of paralysis in Savannah. She was one of the noted midwives of her day. She was the mother of 24 children, 23 being girls. In 1820, my grandmother was born and named after her grandmother, Dolly. My mother, Hager Ann Baker, was born in 1834. 9 children were born unto her. 3 died in infants. I was born August 6th, 1848, in Liberty County under the slave law of Georgia.
So if I'm not free, I guess I need to go to the to continue these minutes, okay?
Yes, ma'am. My wife wants a lot of meat and some gas on the plantation.
What's he saying, Grandma?
Oh, honey, he's just talking there like that.
Yeah, I'm just talking to man.
Why is he so sad?
Well, Shelly lost his faith.
Lost? Ah! They were sold!
What's he mean?
Shakespeare, stop upsetting my little girl.
I'm sorry, don't mind.
Don't you worry, baby. You ain't got that to worry about. You ain't going nowhere but to school.
School? You mean where they learn to read and write?
Yes, and I got it all worked out with Mrs. Woodhouse.
Oh, Grandma!
You gotta be mighty
Shakespeare!
Yeah.
Lord, put my hat back on. I'm raring to go.
mighty crazy. You want to find out? Getting all your guardians like you all these passages.
Well, maybe my guardian is more free than all you other free colored people around here like you, Mr. Stagecoach Man.
I'm just saying. It's going to be the devil to pay if you get caught.
Stop on sticking my little child. Don't worry, don't pay no attention. You're just making a conversation, baby. Let's get out of here before you have another opportunity to set my child.
I don't know if you're out there, but just like my grandma, I need something to believe in too. And if you are listening, please, please, please keep her safe. I promise if you do, I'll try harder to believe in you. Deal?
Thank you. against slavery. He said so right there.
Oh, Susie, who's against slavery for himself? He owned over 60 slaves a day.
But still, I like when he says, give me liberty or give me death. My dreams are getting bigger and bolder all the time.
Really?
When I was a little girl, all I wanted to do is learn how to read. And then I wanted to learn how to write. And then I wanted to learn more and more new things all the time.
You got pretty good at that.
With your help, Katie. Are you sure Miss O'Connor is not here?
Have you been talking to her anymore? I told you, Papa won't be home for hours. Tell me more about you. Come on, tell me.
So I've been praying a lot more lately, asking the Lord, what can I do with all this information? I mean, what good is it really, besides to help Grandma a little? And then it became clear.
And when?
When the Yankees landed on Tiger, I think the Lord was telling me, Susie Baker, you're going to be free.
Oh, you think the Yankees are
going to
win this thing?
I don't know, but ever since the police almost arrested my Grandma because they thought she was singing about the Yankees, they've been on my mind lately, and now, here they are. Well, as Grandma says, it's up to the Lord.
I suppose you're right.
Do you want the Yankees to win?
I guess I'm a little confused about that. All the sisters of the convent say it's not right to have to interview with God's plan. But when I ask what the plan is, they won't tell me. Papa says the Yankees are going to destroy all my blood, but when I go, I do something different.
Go on.
What's this commotion? You little traitor! Take it back! Now!
Well, honey, I need you to do me one favor. When you get
your grandma says hello.
Like a wave of the sea, driven with the wind and tossed.
Hey, you're pretty good.
Pretty good? I've been reading since I was 8 years old.
Is that so? You know, you're the first girl I've met who can read.
Well, you're not the first boy I met that couldn't read.
Well, you mind if I borrow your Bible? Do you know this verse? Let your women keep silent in the churches, for it is not permitted unto them to speak, but they are commanded to be under obedience, as also says the law.
You don't know how to read. Some backward preacher taught you that.
Cease from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any wise to do evil.
And Deborah, a prophetess, the wife of Lapidus, she judged Israel at the time, and she dwelt under the palm tree of Deborah between Ramoth and Bethel and Mount Ephraim, and the children of Israel came into her for judgment.
All right, you got me. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. There is neither male nor female. For all are one in Christ Jesus.
Amen to that. You must be from the city.
Derek. You?
Savannah.
I'm Evelyn King.
Susie Baker.
Are you on your own?
Of course not. I'm with family.
How long have you been here?
On St. Patrick's. We just arrived 2 days ago.
Arrived, huh? I like that word. As if you were just taking another trip.
It does seem a little strange.
Yeah, it takes a while to sink in. You know, I got here last week. I rode down the Altamont Hall towards the sea when a Yankee schooner picked me up. And no one said, "Welcome aboard, you're free now." Hardly anyone ever talked to me at all. They just took me here and told me to wait. And I'm still waiting.
I was told we're going over to St. Simon's in a few days.
Oh, yeah? Well, how come you're out here on your own?
Mr. King.
Mr. King?
It's not your concern if I'm out here by myself or not.
Well, we gotta look out for one another.
I can look out for myself just fine.
Okay, well, listen. The colored people need to hold together. Miss Baker, we're being tested.
By the Lord?
Sure, always by him. But no, I am talking about the Yankees. You know, we have to prove to them that we're a lot smarter than they think. And you and me, we're prime examples.
Thank you.
Believe it, a lot of them have got their slave master's attitude. You know, they think they know what's best for us. And they think that I'll be just fine cleaning their roads or driving their wagons, but give me a musket? Never. And you can be a cook or laundress, but a teacher? No.
Yes.
How's that?
I'm going to be a teacher as soon as we get over to St. Simon's.
Wait, you, a teacher? I don't believe it.
I had an interview with Captain Whitmore. He Commodore Goldsbyer to me and to teach the children on the island. So you see, Edward King, you might have to change your attitude.
Well, teach me how, Susie Baker. Teach me how.
Luke was so frugal that he didn't even spend the penny that his parents gave him. Now, does anybody have an idea? Really?
I don't know, poor?
Is he really poor if he didn't spend the penny that his parents gave him?
I guess not. Maybe he's just
cheap. Oh, we have a visitor.
I'm sorry, I hope you don't mind. I wanted to introduce myself. I'm Captain Kroger. Perhaps we can talk later.
Miss Baker. All right, we'll resume the story a little later. I want you all to practice your grammar skills. Pencil, paper, and silence. The only sound I want to hear is everyone's mind at work. What can I do for you, Captain?
The same as you're doing for these children.
How may I do that?
I understand you've been on St. Simon's since April.
Yes, over 5 months now.
In that time, you've gotten to know the men pretty well.
What?
I'm here to recruit men to fill out a new regiment for former Indian people.
Black men?
Why, yes, that's all you have here.
I didn't think the Army wanted Negroes to be soldiers.
We do. That is, this is our first black regiment. I'm here to see if I can find the best men on St. Simon's to serve. I thought with your knowledge and experience of the men, you might be able to recommend some of them for me. Perhaps that came out wrong.
I think I know exactly what you mean. I can tell you about many capable men on this island. Like Uncle Richard. Any particular qualities you're looking for?
Yes, leadership ability. Someone like yourself, okay? Or someone who commands respect, if at all possible, someone with some education. I must say, you're the first black person I've met in the South who can read and write.
Let me introduce you to your second interview.
Thank you.
Good. Henry?
He is my friend who wears the red shirt.
And here, we ain't known each other.
Why is that? The red shirt's from a mile away.
Maybe don't think that was cool calling them with their mom's death.
Now, I've told y'all I'm working on it. A little indigo goes a long way. Have some patience, please.
Yes, ma'am, Mrs. King. You so wonderful.
Just trying to help out.
Sure appreciate you, Martin.
Yeah.
Say, Sergeant, can't put you up if you deserve my niece.
Not a thing. The good Lord planned this one, not me. Now, let's get back to 10. Huh?
Hey, Tommy. Hey. Men are off duty now. Listen up. Got some bad news. You just heard from headquarters that you will not be receiving any pay. Oh. I know. This is not right. There is some talk that at some point you will be receiving partial pay. I want you to understand that all the officers are on your side. We encourage you to stand up for your full pay. How, you may ask? There is no easy answer. There are 900 of you in this South First South Carolina regiment. And if you, as a regiment, prove your worth to this country, as I know you will, the powers that be in Washington will see that you are entitled to the same pay as your white comrades. I know it may take some time, but justice will prevail.
We've been waiting for that forever.
You will receive clothing, food, and shelter as long as you're serving with the United States Army.
Same as Master Davis?
Very true. At least now you have a choice. I'm sorry to interrupt your evening, gentlemen.
Thank you, sir.
I want you to hear this from me.
We might as well be on the plantation.
No. Did any of you sign up for pay? Did you?
Well, you heard the captain himself say, that ain't right.
And that's true. But you also heard him say we have to prove ourselves first. Now, there are a lot of white people, and I'm not just talking about the Rebs who wants to see us fail. We can't let it happen. And if you want to quit right now, do it. And let the rest of us go about our work. This is our war now.
Let's start over with A. Henry?
A is for A.
Jesse, did you?
Me is a bunch of who I
not anymore. Yes, in Africa. I was told we'd be free there too.
Yes, this really is our country now.
My country is a sweet land of liberty. Land where my fathers died, land of the hill of pride, from every mountainside, let freedom triumph.
No! No! No!
can't.
You can't.
I can't.
We gotta get you to a hospital.
Thank you.
been so tired.
And what about? The white folks ain't even voting out. Screaming at us, we're saving them.
They're gonna change. They have to.
Why? Because they lost the war? Don't mean nothing.
There goes our angel of mercy.
Susie!
I'm much better. Let me help. Did you know Edward once set fire to a barn when he was just a little boy?
Let's keep our pot glass private.
Yes, sir, Sergeant.
You can clean up yourselves. You know I don't like talking about our pot glass in front of the men.
Our lives haven't been private for a long time.
Well, they're going to be pretty soon. In case you haven't noticed, the Rams are on the run. This war is almost over.
So?
So, it's time to start making plans. About what we're going to do and where we're going to go.
Savannah.
How's that?
We should move to Savannah.
Why? Because your grandma lives there?
No, because I know Savannah and it needs us, Edward.
But what about what we need? I'm ready to start a family. And I want to know that our children will be in live in a place where they can have a fair shake.
Isn't this what this whole war was all about? I've heard you say it to the men so often. Them, in other words, them white folks down there are going to have to change.
I say that to them to give them hope. Look, most of these men will have no choice but stay put. And you and me, we got opportunities. We can have a good life in the North. There's nothing holding us back.
You want to start a family, right?
More than anything else.
And I want to start a school. And in Savannah, I can do both. But I'm not telling you with a little stranger.
And you don't want your own?
Of course I do.
So this is about your grandma?
No. I have a gift for teaching. I've done it on this island, and I've done it with these soldiers. And I can see you doing it in Savannah.
So, you have any room for me in there?
Oh, I should slap your face, Edward King. I almost lost my black because I'm here.
All right, I'm sorry. That didn't come out right.
It sure did.
So, Savannah, you think they'll want me there?
Of course. Boston's carpenter skills like yours aren't for me. And besides, we won't be alone. Yeah. Some of the comrades will be there too.
You know, I was hoping for a bigger change.
Nothing's gonna be the same now. It's a new world.
Even in Savannah?
Especially Savannah.
Thank you. afraid I'd be better off in the city.
So this is where you learned to read and write?
Yes, ma'am.
Huh. Very cool. Well, to tell you the truth, Mr. Green and I could hire any number of girls to be our laundress, but we prefer someone with a little bit of education.
I've been very fortunate in that regard.
Have you? Yes, you wrote here that you opened a school for Negro children in 1866. How could you do that?
There were no public schools here for the children then, so I provided them with a private one.
Huh. And you don't have any credentials to teach, do you?
No, ma'am, I do not. But I gained a lot of experience teaching children and adults during the war.
The war? No, we won't be discussing that here. Now, why did you stop offering these classes?
I was about to have a child.
Oh, you're married.
I'm a widow.
Oh, sorry. I wasn't expecting to hire anyone with a child.
My child is with my mother now.
Good. That is. Tell me a little bit more about your activities before you applied for this position.
In April of 1867, I opened a school in Liberty County, but Country Life didn't agree with me.
Nor anyone else with any sense. Go on.
So I returned to Savannah after a year, but most of my students were now attending Beach Institute because it's free. That's when I opened a private night school for adults.
Ma, you really seem determined to teach.
But I also lost those students when Beach Institute opened its own night school.
Well, perhaps my dear wasn't meant for you.
Perhaps not. That's when I put my child with my mother and began working as a domestic.
Oh, yes, and I noticed you did not mention the family you used to work for.
Miss Green, I have done a lot of things in my life under the most trying and dangerous of circumstances, but I had to leave this family because the work was just too hard. I'd rather not mention her name.
I appreciate your honesty, Susie. You certainly do have some impressive references, especially this Colonel Trowbridge, even though he is a Yankee, mind you. Mr. Green and I don't have anything much against Yankees. You do know that this is the very room that General Sherman used while he was here in Savannah.
No, I did not.
Oh, yes. Mr. Green and he became quite good friends. That was before I entered the picture, of course.
You mean this is the room where they held the meeting about 40 acres and a mule?
40 acres and a what?
My grandmother told me all about it. How General Sherman and the Secretary of War met here with the colored church leaders. And they talked about giving everyone 40 acres and a mule.
Mr. Green never mentioned anything about that to me. Oh, church leaders here in this room. Hard.
Well, I'm pretty sure.
No, we will talk past that other trees. We must move on. Now, Susan, I am prepared to offer you room and board and $5 a month salary. You may have Sundays off. You may have no private visitors at any time, and you must report directly to me. Susan, welcome to Green household. We're all one big happy family.
Take a piece of the pies on the sampling table over there. have a number of our ladies who are very eager to know your preference, as well as we still have to award the winner with, may I say, is a very generous prize. Thank you all very, very much. Mrs. Green, you are the belle of the ball.
Oh, my.
We are so pleased and so honored to have you here.
Well, I assure you the pleasure and honor are all mine.
Might I ask you a private question?
Of course.
That colored girl, she's your cook?
Susie. My normal cook couldn't travel north, so I had to bring this girl. She's my laundress.
Oh. The poor thing, she seems so uncomfortable.
Does she? Pardon me, just one moment, please. Bring yourself together. You're embarrassing me. Yes, everyone is staring. You think I mistreat you?
No, ma'am, I don't think they do.
But you know. Straighten up and act like you're enjoying yourself.
Good afternoon, Mrs. King.
Colonel Trowbridge.
It's just Mr. Trowbridge now.
What are you? Why are you here?
For you, Mrs. King. I wanted you to know that you'd be spending the summer in Brighton. I took the opportunity of a business trip to Boston to see if I could find you. And here you are.
It couldn't have been that easy.
Nothing is too difficult for finding an old comrade. You were looking very well.
You as well. This is such a surprise.
Mrs. King, I wanted to tell you that you could be sad about when my husband passed. Sergeant King was an excellent man. Everyone.
How do you do? I'm Mrs. John Winslow.
Charles Trowbridge.
Thank you so much for coming to our fundraiser for St. Louis.
Actually, I'm here to see Mrs. King.
Who?
Mrs. King.
Oh, Mrs. King.
Yes, you served together in the Army.
Really?
Why, yes. You really don't know about Mrs. King?
Well, no, I do not.
When I first met her, she was teaching, St. Simon teaching children, St. Simon's Island in Georgia.
You were a teacher?
I was.
At 13. But then I recruited her to serve with our first Negro regiment in the Army.
At 13.
I was 14 by then.
It was the most dangerous service. She did everything that was asked of her and much more. She was a cook, she was a laundress, she was a teacher, she was a rifle assembler and tester. And did you know Mrs. King was the first black nurse in the history of our republic?
No.
Clara Barton herself, crazy.
Clara Barton?
Yes. I can go on, but I don't want to embarrass you.
Too late for that.
What is it? Very well. You know, this seems so trifling now, but I must announce that we have a winner to the pie baking contest. Will the lady who baked the blueberry pie please raise her hand.
Girl, this woman into my life. Was it to shame me? Please help me to understand what I must do. What president has said about reconciliation? Therefore, if thou bring thy gift to the altar, and thou rememberest that thou brother hath aught against thee, leave there thy gift before the altar and go thy way. First be reconciled to thy brother, and then come and offer thy gift. Susie,
I sent you a note to meet you here. I just came in.
I didn't hear you knock.
I didn't know.
Right. I asked you to knock today.
No, ma'am.
Susie, Mr. Green was courting me, and he brought me to Savannah. Do you know what I like best about his house?
I don't, but I can imagine.
Yes, it's the loveliest house in town. Yes, that's true. It's not what attracted me to it. The fact that it's right here, next to this church. And that's when I knew I should marry Mr. Green. I come here often, you know.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Perhaps I shouldn't ask you this, but are you a believer?
I am.
And you've studied the Bible?
I have.
No one would accuse you of prophecy. I'm trying to say, and believe me, this does not come very easily. I would like to ask you for your forgiveness. You understand me? Say something.
I have something to tell you, too.
What?
I'm giving my notice.
Why?
I'm moving to Boston.
Well, how? How could you do that?
Miss Bernard has kindly offered to pay my way.
Miss Bernard? Oh, she would. Her father's very possible. Why must you go there?
Miss Green, I appreciate the opportunity that you gave me to go north. It really opened my eyes.
Mine too, unfortunately.
I simply feel people would treat me better there.
Have I really been that awful to you? Is that why you won't forgive me?
I am a believer, but I have struggled with my faith. I know the Lord said, if I don't forgive you, then he won't forgive me. But right now, I'm not ready to forgive anyone of your kind.
Oh.
I didn't mean to say this to you, but...
But I asked for it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. When will you be leaving?
Monday.
That soon.
I would have given more notice, but I found out last night.
Boston, yes. Supposedly happy there. I should go travel as well. Don't worry, I won't call you Boston. I was thinking old Europe. Supreme would like that being original. Maybe it'll give you a better perspective of sanity.
I hope so. I really do.
Thank you for that. You feel a little better.
May I go now?
Yes, of course, you don't need to ask for my permission. Well, Lord, at least I got that out of here.
cry. Now let my sweet Susie come to see you. You and Mr. Jack must be doing well for yourselves.
We're fine, we're fine. Mr. Taylor's all occupied with his work, and I'm busy with women's relief court. I'm in a little company. Oh, it's a little organization. Still trying to make sure our men and women are being cared for in the twilight of these years.
All right, then I'm in good company, Grandma.
I really don't mind. Now tell me about that boy of yours.
How's he doing?
That boy is 21, and he is a one. All determined.
No.
You have to follow your dreams. You know I was never like that.
Well, you know, yourself will teach you.
How's Mom? Does she still own that big cell in the doctor town?
Oh, yeah. But why don't you go for your yourself?
Oh, no, Grandma. You know, she's small, too.
But you hardly ever come down here. Oh, this is the last time you visited us.
Years ago, this is not where I want to be.
Oh, I can see that.
As soon as I step a foot in the south, I feel I'm in another country.
Well, this is your home.
Not as long as a black man could be lynched for looking at a woman, a white woman, it's not.
Now, Susie.
When I look back on that day, we all sang, "My country, 'tis a thee, sweet land of liberty." Well, I can't sing that song now.
Don't sing that.
I'm sorry, Grandma. That's the way I feel. And besides, coming back down here, it makes me think of Edward.
Oh, child, rest his soul.
I made a big mistake not listening to him.
Child, we all live from one state to the next. And in between, we just get something right. But all the Lord asks us to do is to keep trying.
I feel I'm 9 years old. And you continue to have faith.
That's all we got. Remember when I lost all my money in the people today?
I sure do. You say it. If the Yankees did take all our money, they freed my race, and that God will take care of us.
And he did just that.
I just wish he'd hurry up and show these white folks the error of their ways.
See, for me, right before you left the walls of the rich white lady, ask for your forgiveness. But you wouldn't take it.
If you haven't missed the people, I was so, so consumed with hate for her
and everything she represented. It was. I should have forgiven her.
Amen. You taught me well. It's just taken me a long time to understand what we've been going through.
What do you mean?
We are similar to the children of Israel who held in bondage for many years, who cried and be forever free from persecution. And I don't despair. The book, which is our guide through life, declares Ethiopia shall stretch forth
her
hand. What a wonderful revolution! In 1861, the Southern Pilgrims